Mr. Kitty Kitty. Rawr. Meow.
Thank you. give Connor the show.
Watcher? I see and write.
Greetings. Saw your notice.
Huh. And they said, where you hang on that, ain't no one else gonna hunt that beast. But I showed him.
Any idea what kind of beast this is?
Oh, you hear all sorts of things. The wenches clean the nets, blather about costchays and manticores. But I reckon that's hogwash. We'd seek the counsel of Freya's priestesses, we would. But how can we when we can't get to the shrine?
And nobody's gotten a glimpse of the beast? From a distance, even?
Oh, they have. Right close. Closer than boot and strap. Soon after, their blood spattered the underbrush. Near from the start, no ordinary man could handle the beast. But Svera insisted. Mustered a crew and... only four came back. The rest massacred east of the village. So, will you help?
I'll tend to the monster.
Not your first, that's clear enough. Not like our lads. Heads full of fire, but not a morsel of thought between them.
The four survivors, where'll I find them?
Aim to talk to Svera. Maybe it ain't a bad idea. They're sitting over there by that hut.
Apart from the worst weather, we're like to get.
Take a soothsayer to know where it's made.
Ask this witcher. He'll tell you monsters don't set traps.
What's the issue?
He or anyone ever heard of a beast setting a wagon in the road, then waiting in ambush? They're too plain dumb for that, damn it.
Dumb or no, they tore a few of our lads to shreds, and we ran like rats. They deserve to be buried.
Willing to talk about it? Tell me what happened.
Ask away.
Remember what the monster looked like?
It were dark. Casper thought he saw something, but...
'cause I did! It was huge. Its maw all blood-smeared. Bugger gutted Ungi with one claw, near spliced him in two.
Word is, you were ambushed. Tell me where.
Short way from here, along the road to Lofoten. Saw a wagon crosswise the road near the woods.
We barely got to it when something came rushing through the underbrush, and whoosh, blood spurted in the eyes. I wiped it away, looked, saw Einar lying dead.
Interesting. Thanks.
For what?
Not much. much left. The beast must have dragged the shredded body to the woods. Something really did tear him to pieces. Looks like blood, but... Red clay. Necker warriors use this clay to mark their position in the pack. The creature leading the Neckers is sentient. Gotta be capable of setting primitive traps, at least. Tracks lead into the woods. Found a good place for their nest. Guess I got company. Oh.
Ooh. We finally take the fight to the black. Maybe they'll learn
So will you help then?
Killed the beast that was troubling you.
Merciful Freya. Horsen's finally dead. Now, tell us, was it a tough fight? Got any wounds need dressing?
No, I'll be all right.
Nothing new to the likes of you. Hard work, witcherin'. All right, your reward. This here's for you.
Thanks. So long. Post the notice?
I did indeed. Hands of Sidaris, mercenary captain. Know of a monster that needs slaying. You interested?
What kind of monster are we talking about?
If only I knew. It was like this. Got Radovid to hire me and my company, but he's been late with the pay the last weeks, and I'll be damned if we're to risk our lives for free, like hell.
Couldn't agree more. But you were gonna tell me about the monster.
Yes, yes. We arrived here, encamped. Then it turned out some beast prowls the area. Snatches cows and the like. Reckoned we should help the local boys, so we grabbed our weapons and set out. Me and Kurt one way, Gerd and Henk the other. Gerd and Henk never returned. Whatever it was, it got him. Jobs for a professional, clearly. So Kurt and me, we chipped in for a small reward, hoping someone's willing to help the locals avenge our comrades in the process.
Awfully noble of you.
Yeah. Mercenaries, we've our honor too. Well, Master Witcher, what will it be? Will you take the job?
Start looking.
South of here. It's where we split up. It's where we last saw Gerd and Henk alive.
Bite marks, armor ripped to shreds. Human, no sign of another corpse. Second body in its claws. Didn't quite get everything to its nest. by piece, follow the thread. End here. Damn birds must have picked the ground clean, but they've already found the rest of the corpse, probably. All I gotta do is follow the cawing. Griffin. Go. Looks like rain.
Well, any progress?
Monster's dead. I slew it. It was a griffin. An arch-griffin, in fact.
In that case, I'm grateful. Arch-grateful. Your reward.
Thank you. And in the future, try summoning a witcher before any blood's spilt.
Thank you. Oh, yes, my bumper ready to blow. Over here, please.
Heard you calling. Wanted to talk?
I did, for we're neck deep in trouble. Of the spider kind.
Need a maid with a broom, not a witcher.
You fail to understand. These are huge. The size of pigs or dogs. Black and hairy, spewing webs.
Mm-hmm. Not talking about spiders then. Talking about arachnomorphs.
Call them what you will. You must smash the rogues, will you? Those caves would be prime barrel storage were it not for the beasts.
Arachnomorphs don't look much like bunnies, but they sure breed like them. Best nip the problem in the bud. I'll look into it.
No. Fetch this empty dead. Sweep up here. Botch it all.
Mountains out of molehills, Vilma.
Oh, yes, should be better than fighting to blow.
I must insist.
You're the safer
man. Much the safer with us at your side.
Balderdash. Lads, I find your concern touching. I do. Yet I've long awaited this day, so you must forgive me, but I shall go through with it as planned. Ah, it seems my guide has arrived.
Greetings.
Greetings to you, White Wolf. I presume you saw my notice. Foolish question. You're here, thus you must have seen it. Forgive me. I should introduce myself. Count Belladar, a great admirer of your deeds.
Thanks. Not something we witchers hear often.
But Count, sir, do you mean to go off with just this witcher? A right hardy fellow he is, no ponce, I'm sure. But your expedition's too risky on the whole. And not taking us with you, pardon my saying it, right daft.
You exaggerate, Vilmar. I believe I can manage to survive half a day without someone there to wipe me arse in my stead. My guards lament, Witcher, but you must forgive them. Now, to get down to brass tacks. As you've no doubt gleaned from the notice, I've a rather extraordinary proposition for you. I'm a lover, Witcher, of nature. A devotee of the wild. And Toussaint is home to several species not encountered elsewhere. I'd like you to accompany me on an expedition whose aim is to preserve them. Ah, yes. Naturally, you'll protect me should the need arise. My ever-vigilant guard, see, will report any reckless behaviour to my wife if I get so much as a scratch. And then woe will be me.
Count Belladar? Famous poultry farmer, is that it?
Well, that was my grandpapa. Dear man. But my trade is the wine trade. I import the finest vintages to Cavir, my homeland. The very reason for my frequent visits to Beauclair, during which I like to, partake of nature, let us say.
Really need a witcher to, partake? Got guards of your own. Take them, save some coin.
I could, surely. But they too deserve a bit of rest, relaxation. Right, lads? Besides, I've plenty of coin. Coin that needs spending. Who dares stop me?
Ah, so this is about a rich man, bored stiff, seeking thrills.
There's also Clarissa, who...
Vilmar, please.
Who what?
My daughter. I always return from my travels with some souvenir or another. She looks forward to them tremendously. But we did not meet to chat about my family. We must discuss our venture, must we not?
Need some details before I can say anything. Where are we going? What am I supposed to do exactly?
In the roundest terms, we shall admire the local flora and fauna. And while we do, I might preserve a thing or two.
Preserve?
Of this device, see, a peristysomach. It captures likenesses.
A pair of sister what?
It's like a movable megascope, capturing moments, transforming them into illusions, based upon which I then paint a painting.
So, you want me with you, looking at animals and flowers and...
Well, that's more or less what it amounts to, yes. Except you will first have to track down the creatures I wish to capture. I know only the very approximate locations of their habitats. Well, and should any trouble arise, we'll have your sword at the ready, right? So, agreed?
Pretty unusual contract.
I couldn't agree more. Yes. And I'm prepared to pay a commensurately high fee.
Don't mind if we actually talk about exactly how high that'll be first, do you?
Why ever would I? Please, simply tell me how much you wish to receive. Sublime! We've a deal!
Doesn't seem hard. Be glad to do something pleasant for a change.
Sublime. In that case, here's your map. Before coming here, I dispatched requests to several local hunters. They located the habitats of the species of interest to me and marked out their ranges on the map.
Good thinking. It'll save us some time. Won't need to track. Ready to go?
I'm afraid we do await the morn. Proper light, see? It's very important. In the meantime... Be my guest at my fire, sir. In fact, I'd be delighted to hear some tales of Witcher life. Well, the wide and wild world beckons. The light now is perfect.
Seems I got the map, so I'll lead. Wouldn't rather be out here with those guards of yours?
You jest. It's deliverance to emerge from under their wings. Believe me, they're overprotective. Oppressively so. I wish to admire the wildlife. Preserve it. Not watch them kill it in a fit of misguided fear for my life.
What if the wildlife attacks us?
Then we shall have no other recourse. I do not wish to be something supper. You? But as long as they remain calm, we've no need to provoke them. It's of the utmost importance to me, in fact. Sharp as a razor, your hearing.
Hear that? Panthers.
Frankly, I did not hear a thing. Clearly, your senses are far more acute than mine. I must rely on them.
Damn poachers. Snares. Looks like they were hoping for a bear. Panther got caught instead.
Oh, come. Will you help the mother?
Give it a shot. Gotta find her first. Likely to lunge at us otherwise.
Brilliant. A superb. Brilliant. A superb image. Folk call witches heartless. This will put the light out.
The Parastisomex upset the animals. Better get out of here.
Cannot abide, poaching. I'm content you share my love for animals.
Got pretty broad interests for a man of the city.
I suppose I dabble in my share of things. Wine, nature, painting. I imagine the life of a witcher must be rather more monotonous. With all due respect.
It is. Never boring, though. Shh. Hear him?
It's those...
Centipedes. Giant. Underground tunnel burrowers. Make a distinct sound. We can use that to track them. Sounds loud and clear here. Must be near the nest. We're here.
Well, this vantage point's no good. I shan't capture a good image from here.
All right, wait. We'll find you a better spot that's safe, too. Tread lightly. Giant centipedes sense the softest sounds, the lightest vibrations. We wait one.
Wait! We better find a safe place for me first! Blast it! I see you're simply unreliable. A place where I would have a good view. Instead, you ran into their lair.
Sorry, got carried away.
Exhilarating. Positively exhilarating. Thank you. I've one more request. Local peacocks performing their mating ritual. I'd love to see that. Apparently, a flock dwells not far from here.
We can go, just don't count on peeping at them while they mate. Season ended a month back.
Oh, that's terrible. I so wish to capture their splendorous tails in full bloom. Is there nothing you can do if they prove uneager to present? Perhaps challenge them somehow? Goad them?
What did you have in mind? Don't have a tail myself, and I'm not likely to sprout one anytime soon.
My thoughts were more along the lines of witcher magic. They say you can exert influence over lesser creatures.
Yeah, guess I can try. Can't promise you anything, though.
Splendid. Consider me contented. I cannot pinpoint the flock's location, but a hunter I know told me a few likely spots. I'll mark them for you.
All right. Let's go find some peacocks. I was wondering, why peacocks?
My daughter is rather fond of them. They will be a treat for her.
We're close. Eyes in the back of your head. A feather from the rump, coated in suet. Cock shed it recently and the suet's got a distinct scent. Ought to be able to track the flock.
A witcher in action. What a treat to watch. Close. Oh, that's lovely. Now, if they could just splay the tails.
See what I can do. Find a good spot.
Ready? Use your magic, Witcher. This'll be a masterpiece! Smile, please!
Giant centipedes! Damn it!
Where did they come from?
Must have followed us. Get back!
That was tense. I believe I've had my fill of excitement for today. What a wonderful adventure.
Get everything you wanted?
Yes.
In that case, time to get back to your camp. Returning your lord to you, safe and sound.
You've our gratitude, Master.
You see, lads, there was nothing to fear.
Thank you, Witcher, for looking after our day count. Seems the jaunt did him wonders. Breathed some new life into him.
Wait here a moment, Geralt. I have to fetch my coin pouch. Pay my dues.
New life? He was feeling down?
Made no mention, did he? 10 years back, his lass, Clarissa is her name, took a spill off her horse. Been bedridden ever since. Cannot walk of her own. She'd been the life of the house before the calamity. A merry sprite what filled every corner with joy. Count would oft take her out on trips. She loved animals too. Excursions he makes now, or rather, paintings he brings home. They's her only window on the wider world.
Sorry to make you wait. Some of your shenanigans proved a little unnerving. Yet I still consider the day a success. Seems even witchers have a sense of humour. Do something deranged at times. Good to know.
Yeah, I'm a wild and crazy guy.
Your reward. Use it well.
Thanks.
I've one other matter I wish to broach. In a few days' time, I shall exhibit my work for some friends, my coterie, so to speak. Would you come by?
Why not, if I'm in the area?
Splendid. In that case, I shall see you at my lodgings. I'm staying with a friend while in Tussaud, near a village named Francolar.
I'll be by. See you.
Good F.
He was a nap.
Both male and female Beauclair centipedes are formidable predators. De Bees preferred to hunt in packs, yet the author of this extraordinary work was able to capture a lone specimen preparing to attack. Cast your eye on the hunter, who, though fully aware of the danger, wears a look of cold determination on his face as he awaits the optimal moment to strike.
Ah, Geralt, you're here. Wonderful. Come, please.
I'm delighted to see you.
I've a small gift for you, and I shan't let you refuse.
You are free to sell it, of course. Though I would be honored were you to hang it in your home.
Thanks. Talked to your guards back at the camp. Told me about Clarissa. Sorry to hear about her accident.
Thank you. Kind words that mean a great deal to me.
How's Clarissa these days? Probably can't wait for you to get back.
To get her gifts, you mean? I've dispatched two already. She'll not need to wait for my return. En route home, I mean to pass through Dol Blathana. They say one can see Sylvan's there.
Yeah, actually happen to know one. Name's Torque. He can be mean, but for the right fee, he'll do anything you ask.
Splendid. I thank you for the hint.
Tell him I send my regards. Good crowd. You got a lot of friends. All of them seem to be fawning over your paintings, too.
Oh, when you have as much coin as I do, friends buzz around like flies on fresh meat. And they praise you to high heavens for each trip, burp and sneeze. Not all are lying sycophants, that's not what I mean. Just most, unfortunately.
Why bother? Why even invite them around?
I'm a man of enterprise. I must put my trade before any personal hatreds or sympathies. Besides? At times, I'll exhibit a completely failed painting just to listen to them twist their tongues into knots, trying to find just the right superlatives to lather on smeared rubbish. Naturally, the more intent someone is to get into my good graces, the louder they praise my masterpiece. It's devilish fun, I tell you.
Nice meeting you. So long now.
Yes, a face no ointment could help.
The blacksmith's wife. She's always showing off the costumes. Yet I hear they bought it all with loans from Cienfanet.
It cannot be.
Thank you.
Come on. Thank you.
these carcasses are
already
Radovid. Hey, you look awful.
You'll choke to death on 3 pounds of steel.
back under your rock.
barbarians.
How you like that silver?
Hey, mate.
Run, Roach.
To death on 3 pounds of steel.
Honor of the father, lad. Stay out of my way.
You'll choke to death on 3 pounds of steel.
Rock. the fatherland.
Fuck.
Long live.
You get up that skull of the canteen.
Your kind spreads disease. Defeatism and desertion.
You'll choke to death on 3 pounds of steel.
Your head out.
My granddad wants to turn from his troubles with a book.
fetched enough to buy him a home.
Stop chattering and help me search.
Giddy up. Move it. Thank you.